In the meantime, though, our fourth major storm in 4 weeks is causing concern for the potential of more severe flooding in some parts of our area. This was the scene earlier today at Camp Ellis, a usual trouble spot during big storms. And that is where our first warning weather coverage continues tonight. News 8's Jackie Couture is live with more. Jackie?
Yes, Steve, as you mentioned, there's always flooding concerns here in Camp Ellis. They are always hard hit. We're actually right here along the seawall. There's just some minor sea splash that's coming up. You might see it from now and again behind me. Nothing too severe at this point. Of course, they are dealing with astronomical high tides, but we're not getting that wind, and that's the problem in most of these storms. So that's kind of saving any of the flooding at this point, though they have more concerns for tomorrow. York County in general has been so hard hit just in the last 3 weeks alone. Just today, they've already seen 2 inches already.
With all the rain, it's been kind of crazy, for sure. Yeah, it's been pretty wet.
Eric Olson and his daughter Janet are taking in the sights tonight at Camp Ellis. They've only lived here for about 5 weeks, a very rainy 5 weeks.
Hopefully it doesn't, you know, take away too much of the beach, but yeah, we're ready for summer.
They're walking on what used to be a paved road until last storm.
It was really bad. The waves were crashing up on the road for a while.
In all, more than 20 inches have fallen in York County in under a month. County officials are keeping a close eye.
I think everybody's a little sick of the rain. I mean, it gets so every week. We start on Mondays out here with big rainstorms. Plus, it's taking a toll on budgets. What money they save for the winter plowing, they've lost in taking care of roads and building back ditches and bridges.
It's been awful. I mean, we've been flooded like this for, like I say, this whole month. It doesn't dry up.
Kathy Chadbourne and her neighbors in Estes Lake Mobile Home Park in Sanford have had enough. The ground's so saturated, there's nowhere for the water to go. And they're getting about 2 more inches tomorrow. That's what's expected anyway. Just to give you an indication of just how strong the storms have been, this was a piece of the road that I would have been standing on here, and now it's just all dirt. So they've been dealing with a lot here at Camp Ellis. Again, there is a coastal flood warning in effect. It will remain in effect through tomorrow morning. The big show here is going to be noon tomorrow. That high tide with the astronomical high tide, there is a gale warning. So the people here in this area, they're so used to it, but they'll certainly be keeping a close eye. We're live in Camp Ellis. Jackie Couture, News 8, Steve.